Hello, everyone. This is another Black Conservative. I am Ryan Bowling. Thank you all for joining me. What I want to talk about in this video is an article I read from Breitbart News that focuses on a Christmas special where Dolly Parton is singing a song where she supposedly is rebuking Satan. And she repeatedly says throughout the song, go to hell, go to hell. You know, she's telling Satan to go to hell. Now, when I read through the article and I listened to the lyrics of the song, I asked myself a question. Was she really rebuking Satan that she claimed that she's doing in this song? Or is this really a mockery of the whole idea of Satan? Remember, this is on primetime TV, okay? So is this a mockery of Satan, or is she really rebuking Satan as a real entity that's causing a significant, causing all this hell that we're going through in this country and in the world? Okay, well, what I'm going to do, I'm going to read just a portion of this article, and I'm going to let you guys listen in on an audio clip of the actual song and lyrics that she sung, and then I'm going to give you my commentary. So let's get right into this article. An article says, country star Dolly Parton performed her hit song, Go to Hell, during a Christmas special where she rebuked the devil on primetime television, proclaiming Satan is real. My brothers and sisters, I am here to tell you that Satan is real, the Grammy-winning songstress said during her Dolly Parton's Mountain Magic Christmas special on NBC, which is primetime TV. And by the way, incidentally, I love Dolly Parton. I never had anything against her, but we're going to go on. I'm going to get into that later on. He is real and walking around amongst us, trying to destroy everything that's good and beautiful, Parton added. He wants to break our hearts and minds, destroy our dreams and plans. He wants to tear us in little pieces, break us down and watch and send us straight to hell. Okay, so here's an audio clip of Dolly Parton singing this song. Now, it seems apparent to me that this special is not new. I've never watched any Dolly Parton specials or whatever. You know, I love her as a singer and so forth, but I never watched any Dolly Parton specials. And what this article seems to indicate that this is something that she's been doing for a while. So, but this is the first time I've ever heard of this song or ever heard of her doing a primetime special. So let's get into this audio clip. Okay, as she can sing, Dolly Parton can sing, man. I remember back in the 80s, what was it, a song she sung with, what was that country star singer's name? Kenny Rogers, I think it was, and I forget the name of that song. God, it was. I love the song. God, what was the name of that song they sung back in the 80s? Islands in the Stream, that was the name of the song. Love that song. I mean, that song became a pop hit, believe it or not. Yeah, you had people in school, a lot of black kids going around singing that song in school because it was such a huge hit. Everybody loved it. Now, let me say something here. Let me point something out here. In the video, it shows Dolly Parton standing on stage. She's dressed in red, this glittery red outfit. And all these people, these choir members are around and they're singing with her and they're clapping their hands and all this type of thing. They're clapping their hands and everything. And this guy comes out dressed in black and these females come out dressed in black. And the guy is supposed to represent Satan, right? He comes out And he's looking at her, kind of like looking at Dolly Parton, like, you know, how dare you tell me to go to hell, right? And all these women are feeling all over him, sexually, he's feeling all over his body. And I'm looking at this and I'm like, I mean, okay, on an entertainment level, yeah, I get it. You got to make it appealing to the people that's watching it on primetime TV. But I can't help but wonder, is this a mockery or a sexualization? You know, they're sexualizing this whole concept. But let's go on. Let's go on with this. You know, I'm going to give you details. I'm going to give you more of my commentary on this. So after she sings this, the article says, here's something she says. The singer went on to declare, oh, my God can do anything. My God can heal the sick. Yes, he can. I mean, you know, God can heal the sick, mend broken hearts, and take our souls to heaven. So, Satan, listen up. In God's name, I rebuke you. I stand in his name, look you in the eye, and laugh in your ugly face. Okay, now, I'm going to come back to that in a minute. But I wanted to end, I want to read a portion of this article here, another portion of this article here, that I think is very interesting. Because this is something that stood out, and it's like, okay, what's the connection here? Is there a connection? Article says, on Sunday, Parton revealed that she has officially joined the Chinese mind control app TikTok, adding, quote, better late than never. So is there a connection there between her telling Satan supposedly to go to hell, and yet you join an app? Or what this article suggests is that she's supposedly telling Satan to go to hell, right? But yet she joins, social media platform that's clearly a Chinese-run mind control app, as this article says. Well, I don't know about how mind control. Let me just rephrase that, because that to me sounds a little bit stretching it. But suffice it to say, TikTok has been accused of being a surveillance app that gets information of people here in America. So this seems to suggest to me that you're telling Satan to go to hell, right? But yet you join in on an app that's controlled by the Chinese Communist Party, who are atheists. No disrespect to people who are atheists. You're an atheist. But I'm not. And she clearly doesn't seem to be. But yet you join an app and you let it be known that you join, you know, you join this app that's supposedly run by the Chinese Communist Party, and they're atheists. But you're telling Satan to go to hell. I don't know. It sounds weird to me, right? So let's go on. The country star already has more than 514,000 followers on the Chinese-owned app, which is Chinese surveillance and psyops thinly veiled as a social media platform, as I said earlier. Now, I wanted to bring, that's the end of that article there. Now, first, let me point out something. I know this is usually not the pattern that I deal with on a common basis on this channel, but sometimes I do. Sometimes I do cover things that I think is important, not only to myself, but important to some of the viewers that watch my videos. And yes, I believe in Satan. As an ordained minister, I believe in Satan. I believe in the spiritual realm. I believe in fallen angels. I believe in demonic spirits. I believe these things because the Bible, which I believe is the word of God, teaches that these spiritual realities exist. And I believe they're manifest in our physical three-dimensional realm through people and institutions. That Satan has an ultimate goal. The demonic spirits and fallen angels that have followed him in his rebellion have a goal. They have a vision. They have an aim. Okay, for this entire world. Now, the other thing I wanted to point out too is that I believe Satan is not some man dressed up in a red suit with a pitchfork and horns. That is a worldly description that people have given him. That is basically a mockery of Satan. One writer said, one of the greatest ways Satan have fooled the world is to convince them that he doesn't exist. But there is a realm that we can't physically touch or see, but is just as real, in fact, more real than our three-dimensional realm that we live in. Many researchers believe that our three-dimensional realm is just a holographic imagery of a spiritual invisible realm. Okay, so this physical realm that we live in is not all there is, at least that's what I believe. Okay, now, having said that, I wanted to point out something here. Number one, I believe that though Dolly Parton is sincere in what she's trying to communicate, I believe that this song and the imagery that's presented in the particular song and the dance sessions that she's doing, I believe the imagery is a mockery of Satan. A mockery of Satan, but at the same time, a centralizing or centralization of Satan. Or not centralization, but a sexualization of Satan. It's sexualizing this whole concept. Now, if you watch the video, if you log onto the description box, go to the description box, go to www.breitbartnews.com and look up the title of that article and watch that video clip. You will know what I mean if you haven't seen this on TV. It's very sexualized. And I believe that is done subversively to the viewers. Supposedly, she's telling Satan to go to hell. But at the same time, this man comes out dressed in all black, very sensual. Like, he's a very handsome looking, he's a very handsome man. And he comes out, shrunks, saw that, and all these women feeling all over him, essentially feeling all of them, all erotic, feeling all over his body. Come on, man. It's sending mixed signals. The other thing, too, that I wanted to point out is that, as I said, I believe she's sincere in what she's singing about. I believe Dolly Parton is a Christian, and I believe that she believes in the spiritual realm. But when you go on primetime TV, you just can't come on there and say whatever you want to say. Especially when it comes to Christianity, because primetime TV and this society hates Christian. I mean, I'm just going to be real with you. They hate Christian. Hollywood hates Christianity, period, bottom line. They hate anything that has to do with Christianity. Everything else they protect, but they hate Christians, okay? You just can't come on there and say whatever you want to say. They're going to tell you this is what you can say and this is what you can't say. So she could only say what I believe they allowed her to say. And here's an example. Supposedly she says, I rebuke you in the name of God. I rebuke you in the name of God. Now, if you read the New Testament, whenever the apostles rebuked a demonic spirit out of a person or cast a demonic spirit out of a person, they always said in the name of Jesus Christ. They never said in the name of God. What the heck does that supposed to mean? What do you mean in the name of God? I believe that was purposely by the people that told her to say, you can't say the name of Jesus. Even if she wanted to say the name of Jesus, I'm pretty sure they said, you can't say the name of Jesus. You can only say in the name of God. Because you can't say Jesus, which is crazy. It's like, what is wrong with someone saying the name of Jesus Christ? What? Oh my God, you said Jesus Christ. If anything, you ought to be praising God. I mean, come on, man. Well, I mean, y'all, I'm a Christian, I'm a preacher. But it's like, what's wrong with saying the name of Jesus Christ? Why are you bothered by that? Why? And so what I believe what they've told her is that you can't say the name of Jesus in this video. You can only say in the name of God. What do you mean by in the name of God? You can't rebuke Satan in the name of God. You know, so I believe that was purposely taken out. So that's my summation of this. I believe that this is a mockery of what I believe to be the reality of Satan, which is a fallen angel, a fallen angelic being, very, very powerful, who was ousted out of heaven because he wanted to be like God. A myriad of other fallen angels followed him in his rebellion. They landed here on earth. They exist in the unseen, invisible realm that we cannot see, but they influence and control and manipulate the three-dimensional realm that we can see. He is an extremely powerful, wise, knowledgeable entity that is not to be trifled with. This, in my opinion, is a mockery of that. And it's taken lightly, this whole idea. Anytime primetime TV does something that has to do with Christianity or the Bible, it always mocks it one way or the other. And this is clearly the way I see it, a mockery of that. Even if Dolly Parton may have been sincere, as I said, she may have been sincere and may have wanted to say some things that she couldn't say, but the editors and producers and executives told her, you can't say these things. That's just my opinion on it. So that's what I believe. What do you guys think? You think it's a mockery or you think this is just some cute little thing she's doing? What do you think? Leave your comments in the comment section below. Like, share, and subscribe to the channel. God bless you all, and see you again.